Hello, thank you for joining this peer exchange titled Management of Beta Thalassemia. Now, beta thalassemia is a hereditary blood disorder with limited approved treatment options and severe comorbidities. Patients are generally transfusion dependent, and that can lead to iron overload. To discuss these challenges, I'm joined by a panel, all experts in the field of hematology, and during the next 90 minutes, we're going to discuss therapeutic options and highlight emerging agents for the treatment of beta thalassemia. I'm Dr. Peter Salgo. I'm a professor of internal medicine and anesthesiology at Columbia University College of Physicians and Surgeons, and I'm associate director of surgical intensive care at New York Presbyterian Hospital in New York City. Joining me today are Dr. Maria Domenica Capellini, a professor of internal medicine at the University of Milan in Milan, Italy. Dr. Thomas Coates, section head of hematology at the Children's Center for Cancer and Blood Diseases and professor of pediatrics and pathology at the University of Southern California Keck School of Medicine in Los Angeles, California. Dr. Farzana Sayani, the director of the Penn Comprehensive Adult Thalassemia and Penn Comprehensive Sickle Cell Programs, and assistant professor of medicine at the Hospital of the University of Pennsylvania in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. And Dr. Sujit Seth, the professor of pediatrics and director of the Division of Pediatric Hematology Oncology at Weill Cornell Medical College and an associate attending pediatrician at New York Presbyterian Hospital, Weill Cornell Medicine in New York, New York. Thank you all for joining us. So why don't we start with the basics? What is beta thalassemia and what is its pathophysiology? How do we do that?
Beta thalassemia is an hereditary anemia due to molecular abnormality of a gene which is involved in production of hemoglobin, okay, the beta globin gene. So it's a recessive defect, so this means that two parents must be carrier to give rise a child affected. And the severity of the disease has a huge spectrum, even in the beta thalassemia setting, due to the different abnormality of the gene. There are many mutations, so they are different.
So we've got some are transfusion dependent, some non-transfusion dependent.
Exactly. Under the spectrum or the definition of beta thalassemia, the most severe one are transfusion dependent, and some of thalassemia patients are non-transfusion dependent. But let's go to the pathophysiology of the disease,
please,
because that is quite important. Anemia is the driver of the disease, severe anemia, and this is the consequence of the imbalance between alpha and beta globin chains, which actually represent the structure of hemoglobin. The globin to produce hemoglobin start in early life, of course, in embryos and then in fetuses. And there is a switch from fetal to adult hemoglobin. At birth, the majority of hemoglobin is adult hemoglobin composed by alpha and beta. So if we are dealing with a beta defect and the production of beta is reduced, the alpha globin chain will be free. They don't combine. And this alpha chain precipitate within the erythroid progenitors during erythroid differentiation, and they give rise to ineffective erythropoiesis. Ineffective erythropoiesis means that there is a clear reduction of production of red cells. That means
That's
anemia.
It.